This video is about using water to paint ratio in watercolour. I'm going to show you how I change the consistency of the whites that I'm using to create different effects. Now while I'm working on this painting for one of my video tutorials, I thought I'd add some water, some like a frothy, surfy feel to it for this dolphin. I know it's all covered in masking fluid at the moment, isn't it? So I'm just working all this, working with watercolour whites. Now I've done quite a few videos here on YouTube when I've been working with watercolour whites, and I know it's not everybody's cup of tea, I realise that, be it watercolour whites or white gouache, anything like that will do, but I use it for highlighting certain areas, like this for example. I'll be using that for all of the surf as well, which would be nice to do, won't it, using that white over the top. But the good thing about white is that you can play around with it. You know, you can have it very loose, very watery, like that there. Look, see how watery that is? Extremely watery, actually. When you apply that, being a watery consistency, you'll find it fades as it dries. So I'll show you what I mean. So when I apply it to here, that's quite watery. I can get even watery than that, look. So really, really watery. I know, that's really watery. Now if I go for a much thicker, creamier version, not really thick though, still want to be able to paint a line with that without it breaking. If it's too thick, that line will break. And this is more of a creamy consistency. Look at that. See the difference? So when you work with watercolour white, and you're working on something like the surf, all these areas here, for the water, then what I want to do with this is by having the more paler, watery version for like a background. And then on top of that, I can just build on the top of it, can't I, by adding these extra speckles and washes of detail. Something like that there, look. But not all over. Leave some of the background still in there. And by doing this, it acts like another plane, doesn't it? Another level as we're working with this, which I get excited about when I start to see something like this, you know, kind of come together, you know? Also, there's always an also. Something else you can do with this as well is that you can add colour over the top with watercolour white. You can! Or opaque white, or white gouache, or even white acrylic. I know, I used to use white acrylic paint quite a lot, actually, within my highlights within watercolour. But that made it more of a mixed medium, didn't it, really? I want to try and keep to watercolour. And this is classed as watercolour. There's white, okay? It's not gouache. Gouache is normally more of a kind of thicker, opaque consistency, more pigment within the colours. So if I just put this a little bit on there a minute, I'll show you what I mean. You've got to wait for it to dry first, though, before you put a wash of colour over the top. So I'm just going to put a little bit around there. So if I wash that brush out, I'm going to get a mixture I'm working on for this tutorial, which is a mixture of phthalo green and Payne's grey. I'm going to add that over the top, just in places, just here and there, just to tint it down, a little bit of a tint here and there, like something like that. You know, and I'm not trying to follow that reference photograph per se. I'm not at all. You know, I'm trying to make it up as I go along, on the same kind of idea as a photo, using the artistic license, so to speak. You know, brighten those colours up in places. The only thing with watercolour white is that it can be quite deaden, you know, can deaden that painting quite a lot, can't it? So that's why sometimes you'll add a little bit of white on the paper, and then over the top of that, a little bit of colour in places like that, okay, a little bit more around there. Just switch to some cerulean blue, which I've just got there. Nice and watery. That's it. Get a little bit more colour in that, I think. Something like that. And I can use that one as well, just to add a little bit of blue in places, just to change that froth. Just a little bit here and there. And again, if it's too much, I'll let it dry, and then I can go over the top of that again with a little bit more watercolour white. Hello! And the other way you can do this as well, to get the extra effects on the water, especially something of this sort of nature, is by splattering.
So I'll show you that next. Check out the video to the top right, and I'll see you there.